Welcome to No Cover Music Magazine. I'm your host, Tim O'Brien, here at American Guitar Boutique in Phoenix City, Alabama, where we're happy to showcase and spotlight local musicians and artists. Welcome to this week's episode of No Cover Music Magazine at American Guitar Boutique, 707 13th Street, Phoenix City, Alabama. Today on the show, we have Miss Jessie Wilson. We're super happy to have her. I hear your name all over town. You play quite a bit.
Yes,
that's really cool. You mostly duo?
Yes, mostly duo. Sometimes solo and then sometimes with full band, but lately it's just been me and my guitar and another person on their guitar just doing duo gigs, but yeah.
That's cool.
Pretty much every weekend or every other weekend.
We always find that people, as much as they like to hear me talk, they want to get right to the music, so I'm looking forward to hearing some stuff. You have some original tunes for us tonight?
Yeah, some original tunes. I don't have as many as I'd hope to have, but I'm working on, in 2018, writing more, so.
That's awesome. That's always a task. Yeah. What are you going to play for us first?
I Knew. It's an original song that I wrote about 2 years ago.
Okay.
About you before.
So that was a pretty heavy song. What was going on in your life when you wrote that?
Oh, goodness. I didn't know we were going to go there on television. A boy, obviously.
Yeah.
It's not prepared to talk about that. Yeah, just your, you know, I guess your casual breakup song, but a little more darker. Basically knowing someone more than they know themselves. And then finally they, you know, learned what I had known the whole time. And so that's probably all I'm going to keep it at. I'm going to keep some secrets. But, yeah, it was a sad place in my life, heartbrokenness and a little bit of depression. But thankfully through that song
the beauty
and
of music.
Yeah.
Music is healing.
Yeah, I came out of that, so.
And you're getting ready to do a recording project.
I am.
Where are you recording?
I'm recording with Justin Blue.
Awesome.
Yeah, he's phenomenal. You know, he plays like 300 plus instruments. But,
all well.
Yeah, very well. And so we're recording a new song that I'm writing right now, currently, next week actually. And so that'll be released
in the
next.
You have a title on it?
You shouldn't ask me that. What's the title? So much pressure. I just forgot it.
Well,
I should have known. Should have known.
You should have known what the title was.
I should have known.
So tell me about growing up as Jessie. Music in your house? Did your parents play?
No, I'm pretty much an alien. I grew up in Phoenix City, right here in Phoenix City, my whole life. My dad didn't play music. Construction worker. My family owns Wilson Realty over here. So, they were kind of that. My Uncle Daryl does play a little bit of the accordion and guitar and things like that, and my grandfather did, but primarily just my uncle and me. So I kind of picked it up in high school, dated a guy who was in like hard rock music and, you know, bands, or like heavy metal and things like that, and he played drums, and I was a cheerleader, which is totally opposite spectrums. And then I liked going to his practices and watching his shows and carrying his drums, and I always loved singing and loved Taylor Swift at the time, and she was like my biggest idol back then when I was like 16. And so I decided to teach myself, so everything that I do is from my own teaching.
That's really cool. You're going to do another tune for us. This one's original as well?
I am, yes. This is the first song I ever wrote. Justin Blue recorded it. And it's on iTunes. It's called Just In Time. I was 17, so it was almost 10 years ago.
All right. Take the pictures off the shelf. I've got to find myself. Got lost in it all. Life is not a fairy tale, and so I tell myself I'm losing touch. With the world around, I'm breaking down on my knees, with nowhere to go and nobody to see. And so I sing. Thank you.
Man, that's a great tune.
Yeah.
You should write more.
Thank you. I know I need to. I'm a first grade teacher in Columbus, so I haven't really put as much time into it as I needed to, which it's hard trying to battle two careers. So I got my love for music in high school, and then didn't really know. I was kind of nervous through the Nashville thing. I kind of felt like I needed a backup, so I went into teaching, kind of because my sister did it, kind of because I didn't know what to do at first, and wound up loving it, and I've always loved kids, so kind of stuck with it, and it kind of came my number one, and music kind of fell down, which is not the way I had intended, but...
Do you drag your guitar into class and
yeah,
play
I do.
For the kids?
Yeah, I do play for the kids, and I sing for the kids, and they love it, and they watch my videos online, and some of them come to my gigs, so...
It's probably a reoccurring question, but I tend to like to ask people, with all the young people that are in this town that are so talented, with kids coming up, and I'm sure you're a role model to as many people that were role models to you. So what do you tell kids as an inspiration in getting into music? I mean, do you have a direction for them, or do you tell them run, go the other way?
Well, I tell them, that I try and inspire them that, they can teach themselves, and some kids, that's not easy. I also give guitar lessons, so I just encourage them to keep doing it. And when I started, obviously, I was no good. I mean, I look back at recordings and I'm embarrassed, but, I tell them the more practice, the better you're going to get. And as long as you love what you're doing, that's all that matters. So now I am 10 years later, a little bit better and, a little bit more knowledgeable.
Who has been the beacon of light or huge inspiration for you? What drives you to keep at it?
As far as music?
Yeah.
I have several influences that I look up to, but it's super hard because I've always tried to pinpoint my sound, and a lot of people ask me, like, what do you play? And so the majority of my gigs are cover music. Play anything from Southern rock to country to 90s rock. I love 90s since I'm a 90s baby. But I'm sorry. Can you tell me your question again?
That's
your brain right there.
Better than that. Why don't you play some music for you that inspires you?
I'll play some Fleetwood Mac. I enjoy her, and everyone always requests that. So this is Landslide.
Okay. Thank you. So you've been playing. Tell me the venues if people want to go out and hear you play. I know you play around this valley a lot. What venues can people catch you at?
I play at Wild Wing Cafe in the Columbus one, and as well as the Opelika one. I'm also getting ready to start playing at Smoke, the new restaurant and bar downtown Columbus. I have kind of branched away from this area a little bit. I just wanted some new places. So I've been in Dadeville a lot at a place called Copper's Grill. I've been in Auburn at Fat Daddy's, as well as Wild Wing, like I said, in the Opelika area. But those are mostly my normal places
to
play.
Now, I've seen you perform at the Loft.
Yes, I do play at the Loft, yes, every now and again when I'm lucky enough to play with those guys. But Jessie Shelby and all those guys, Neil Lucas, are great there.
All of those guys have been on the show, so
yeah.
Good company on the
yeah.
show. So where can someone go and hear your music? I know you said you're coming out with a new single. If people are searching out your stuff, where would they go to find it?
You can go to my Instagram. It's at Jessie Wiltson Sings, J-E-S-S-I-E Wiltson Sings. And then my Facebook, I post videos as well, just Jessie Wiltson on Facebook. I also have a YouTube channel that I have about 5 videos on right now, and I'm hoping to record more and be more consistent with that. So those are the locations. For
promotion is a constant in this business.
It is.
Let's hear you do another tune for us.
Yeah.
What do you want to do?
I'm going to do a classic from my childhood by Dina Carter called Strawberry Wine.
Awesome.
I was thirsting for knowledge. all everything. My first taste of love, it was bittersweet. That green old vine, like strawberry wine.
There's a certain simplicity to playing just by yourself with an acoustic guitar that I like. Do you perform different stuff in a full band unit, or do you pretty much do a lot of the regular sets?
So it's kind of the same stuff mostly, sometimes different songs obviously that I feel are, you know, high energy that I just need and want those guys with me or girls to play, you know, back up with me. But like you said, there is simplicity to acoustic, and I started out acoustic just at, you know, Iron Bank and Fountain City and all the places in this area. So I started playing guitar, which I don't think that I'm that good at it, honestly. I learned to teach myself because I wanted to accompany myself. And when I was 16, 17, I didn't know anyone to play with me, and I wasn't really brave enough at that time to ask and, I guess, get in the loop of the musicians being so young. So I kind of taught myself just so I can accompany myself.
Well, that was, you led into my question, because I was going to ask you if you consider yourself a singer that plays guitar,
yeah,
or a guitar player that sings.
No, definitely a singer that plays guitar.
All right.
But I don't even know if I can say that I'm a singer, because I haven't had formal training, but I enjoy, I'm a person who sings and a person that plays guitar.
Well, you know, you don't always need formal training. You're a teacher, so you get both sides of it. But we really appreciate you being on the show. Jessie Wilson. Jessie Wilson sings.
Yes, on Instagram.
Make sure and check her out. If you see her playing live, local, go support her and support the Chattahoochee Valley music scene.
Thank you so much for having me.